So today we'll be starting with database programs in VB6. And I would prefer we use the non-standard control more. So we'll be using database programs and we will not be using any standard control. So in that, what I would want first is we create a MS Access database named hospital and save it as type 2002-2003. So first go to MS Access, search for MS Access. Here you get 2010 you have. You have 7 also? You don't have 7. So just search for the Access version on this machine. You have 2013. Okay, click here. Go to blank desktop database. Give the name to the database. What is our database name? What have we thought of?
Hospital.
And go on, click on this browse folder and save the location. So I go over here, D drive. We have a program stored, ma'am. C drive. Okay, SEM4, Visual Basic. And here I'll make a new folder, database non-STD, non-standard. And enter. And choose which save as type was what? Save as type. That should give you the .mdb extension. This saving should give you .mdb, Microsoft Database Extension. So I go over here and choose 2002-2003 format. Okay, that should give you the .mdb extension. Now click on create. Once database is created, what is the next step? Create a table named Doctor having the following columns, D number, D name, address, and phone number, and these are the data types. D number will be number, D name, address, and phone number should be text. So right click over here. They give you a default table by the name table one. Right click, go to design view. Name the table. What name should I give?
Doctor.
And what should be the first column? D number. What type? Use number. Next. D name. What type? Short text. Next. Address. What type? Short text. And phone number. What type? Short text. Make sense? No. Phone number will be 10 digits. No? So it might go out of range of a number. So better we take short text. Clear? Save it. And time being, you can close the database because this is done. Clear? Now go to step 3, what? Design the VB form with how many labels? 4 labels, 4 text boxes and 1 command button. So let's open a VB form. A fresh VB form open. Set the font size to be once and for all 18. Okay, done. Take 4 labels. First label will be enter doctor number. Next, so copy this, paste it. Why do you want to create a control array? Say no and align it properly. Enter. I'll pause the recording here so we don't consume much space. So this is what we have designed so far. So step number 3 also is sorted. Design the VB form with 4 labels, 4 text boxes and 1 command button. I've added a note over there, drag and drop ADODC control. Now this control you will not see in the toolbox. So to add this control, let me add a disclaimer over here. How do you add this control? ADODC control. You got to right click on the toolbox and then go to components. In that, hit M for Microsoft, button of the keyboard,
and you will see check the okay, let's do it. Right click, components, hit the M button, and you see over here Microsoft ADO Data Control 6.0. What do you see? Microsoft ADO Data Control 6.0. You check the checkbox over here and apply OK and OK. What happened? Okay, and you get the control over here. Fair enough. Drag that control on the form and set its visible property to false. I've written over here. Okay, once this is done, it says add the ADODC control on the form. This is how you add it and set its visible property to. So you choose it, go to where? Visible and set visible to false. I don't want to see it on the form. When I play the control project, I don't want to see ADODC. Visible set to false. So far, so good. Now establish a connection with this control and the database. That should be our next step. So step 4 is right click on the ADODC control. And these are the steps which we need to follow them. Go to properties, then go to build. So right click, go to ADODC properties. Over there, next step is go to build. Okay, I've chosen build. Next, what do I choose? Jet 4.0 as my driver. So Jet 4.0. Go to next. Then browse. Then you have a browse for the hospital.mdb file. So you have a browse button over here. And where is that file? SEMFO, Visual Basic, and database non-standard, right? Database non-standard. In that I have hospital.mdb. And then you can test also if you want to. Test the connection. Succeeded. Click on OK. Click on OK. Now, this connection string which we get, I want to copy this. Use the connection string, this entire connection string. Go to the start and copy the entire connection string. Entire, head to toe, total. So it says, copy the entire connection string from the wizard and paste it on the form anywhere. So I go to the form and I paste it anywhere. Let's say I paste it at form load. Just paste it. It'll throw an error. Ignore the error for the time being. Okay. So far, so good. Now it says, declare the following variables on the code window. How many variables do I need? 3. One for the connection, one for the result set, and one for the string. So now I go to my coding window. This is my design window. From there I double click. I go to the coding window. I go above form load and declare what? Public con as new ADODB dot connection. Public RS as new ADODB dot record set, and for the query I write public query as string. Make sense? And now to establish the connection where we have pasted this, just write con dot open, con dot, and this entire query in double quotes, entire connection string in double quotes. That's all. And give a message box for confirmation. Message box database connection established, if you wish to. Not compulsory, but it's better we give. So now whenever I play my application, I'll get this message first, database connection established, then I will get the form. Now what do I expect over here? I want to enter the details, 101, doctor name, address, and phone number 9890123123. And when I click on insert, what should happen? This record should be added to my doctor table in the database. Clear? So now let's do that. So the remaining code will be on the click of the insert button. So command one, click. First, prepare the query. So let's populate this. Now, once this is step 5, then what is step 6? Tell me. What was step 6, which we just did that? Add which function? Add form, load. Do what? Con dot open and double quote the entire connection string which we had copied, and a message box confirming database connected. That was step 5. Now what will be step 7? Step 7 will be at what event? At command 1 underscore click. What do we do? Write the query first thing. So step 7a. Step 7a, what to do? Write the query. So this will change as per the program. So if it's an insert question, then insert, delete question, then update question, then update query. So write the query. So we are doing which program? We are doing insert, right? We are doing insert. So we'll write the insert query and store it in the query variable. So what is the query for insert? I'll write the query neatly in the over here. So query equals to what? Insert into table name. Insert into table name. Hospital is the database. Doctor is the, so you will insert into the hospital or into the doctor? Insert into doctor. And what? Values. Wherever there is a data type as number, directly use double quotes. Directly use double quotes and ampersand. No space between them. And what? Text one dot text space and double quotes and a comma. There is no space between this. Space is always between the and the T. T and the and. Space is between and T, and there's no space over here. Second is what? Doctor name is number. It's text. So for text, add an extra single quote. Add a single quote, double quote, and no space. And now text, two dot text. And double quote, single quote, comma. Next. Address, again it's text, single quote, double quote, and text, three dot text, space, and double quote, single quote. And fourth is, which we have taken as text. So single quote, double quote, and text, four dot text, and double quote, single quote. Bracket of values. This bracket, I need to close. And this double quotes which I have opened in the start over here, this also I need to close. This also I need to close. So I will close over here. Clear? I'll copy this entire query and paste it over here. So the query is this. Clear? So this is your bullet. To fire this bullet, we need a gun. That gun is RS. So what will you do? RS dot open. Which query are you firing? The query which is in the query variable, which is active connection, comma, CON, and comma, choose the first option. Use the down arrow key, first option, tab, comma, second option, tab, done. And then give a message box saying, record inserted. And then after that, set the RS equals to nothing, blank the RS. Clear? Save the program. Save it where you have made the database file. So where D? Where in D? SEM4. Visual Basic, Database Non-Standard, Form 1 save, Project 1 save. Add to source, no. And now let's open the database file. SEMFO, Visual Basic, Database Non-Standard, Hospital Database. Do you see any record over here? No. Let's try inserting a record from the front end. So I play this. Doctor number 101, Alice, address, camp, and phone number 98221121222, 10 digits, and I click on insert. I get what? Record inserted. And when I go to the database and I refresh over here, I see that record. Clear? This is your database program. Simple as that, okay? This is the design. This is the code part of it. This is the design part of it. Database connectivity using non-standard.